Start recording. All right, how's it going, everybody? Welcome. If I remember right, we finished up the 2017-2018 season. We got through all of that stuff. Oh, hopefully that heartburn medicine kicks in because it is just like messing with me today. But we do off-season recruiting and we'll be getting ready for that. So we will get set up. And I'm tired. I don't know why I'm so tired. I got decent sleep today. Although I did get waken up by maintenance because they were checking fire alarms. So things could have gone better. All right, yeah. So we want our seniors. Actually, we'll just do it like that because that'll give us a solid idea. I think at this point we there's no one else to really compete with these three guys. So, I mean, just as long as we keep up on our phone calls and such, I think we'll be okay. Realistically, I'm looking towards next year already. This, you know, Lance Head, 5-star recruit, looking towards him. Let me see here. I want at least the... let me look at some of the other ones here. So, yeah, I think we're going to have decent shot at these guys, too. So I think we've kind of already got it, and I think that's a decent spread as well of even 4- and 3-star. I wonder if there's any more 4-star guys. That is another one I should look at. All right. Let's look at, 4 stars, and then... Yeah, we'll separate them by about that, and we'll see if there's any of them I might have a chance at grabbing. Oh, no, I already have him, don't I? Anyone who hasn't already pretty much figured out exactly where they're going to go? No. I mean, I could try that, but that's a long shot. 6'10 power forward. Prosper Maddox, by the way, is quite the name. All right, I'll give him a ring a ding, and we'll see what happens here. It's still a long 8, but I'll kind of push him in there. But yeah, maybe. Like I said, all I really need now is to just kind of take a look at everybody. I mean, I got enough points. I might as well like throw some guys on the target list. Have some options available to me. Do I need a shooting guard? I mean, I could probably use a shooting guard. If not, he seems good enough to make small forward. I would be top 5 already for this guy. And he is a small forward, but heavier dude, too. Maybe we can request the game tape of both these guys. And we'll get a much better idea of who we could probably go with. His athleticism is good. His shooting, though, is good, and his defending. So, the JUCOs. I could do the JUCOs. I should probably look at the JUCOs. Let's see if there's any dudes there. Well, I don't know if they're gonna... That's the thing, is I think they're pretty much gonna sign with people right now. So, at this point, I've got my 3 guys offered. Like, I got my 3 guys for this year. I'm looking at juniors for next year. That's where I'm looking here. I should try to find some guys from Iowa. That might be the thing. Ooh, that's a close 2. Maybe I should try to find some guys who potentially. Let's go ahead and. They don't have a lot of guys here. Okay. Junior. They got 2 juniors. Wow. Is this it? Really? Realistically, this is. Yeah, Drake can have them. This guy, we'll take a look at him. Why not? I think just us talking to him is going to get us in the hunt pretty quickly. So, we'll throw him in there. So, I'm just keeping my options available for juniors. So let's make do this and go there and there, there and there, there. So that way I still at least have, because if you see here, I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I got 7 guys. I don't know if I can cut people now to try to use more. Let me look. I don't think I can cut people now to try to make room. Not to mention, we have quite a few, you know, skilled guys as is that really aren't that bad. We kind of cut a lot of the fat already. So we bring in the 3 guys. Some of these guys will do well. Let me see. Is there any seniors? 1, 2. Oh, God. All right. 3, 4. All right. So... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So we'll have 4, 10, 13 total with the people that we're signing and the people that are leaving. Let me make sure that I actually did what I needed to do with all my juniors and seniors. Yeah, see, I'm already... Yeah, Mr. A plus recruiting. And I don't need to, and the good thing is I don't need to spend a lot of points on the other ones because the seniors are pretty much there. They are there. I have them. All I gotta do is just kind of finish signing them up. Go. Let's do that here. Whoops. All right, so targets. Yeah, there you go. See that shit? Email, phone, email, phone, email, phone. This is realistically... to be fair, this is super simple. This is going to be probably one of the most simple recruiting off seasons I've had because the three scholarships are already like in the bank. They just need to sign it. And the rest I've kind of been dealing with over the last year anyway, so we'll see what happens. Knowing that the 5-star guy might not be there. Gotta love Century Link in the country. There you go. Number 1 signed. Number 2 signed. Number 3 is not signed yet. That's fine. As I say, Century Link for you. Must suck, but CenturyLink's always been really good to me, though. They've always been pretty on the ball for me. With the exception of trying to sign up for shit. It really depends, I guess, on the time of year that you're trying to make things happen. Because I think they... I think... Because when I got my new internet set up this past August, they were out here within like 2-3 days. Like they were able to sign me up. Like, yeah, we could be out there. Today's Monday. We could be out there Wednesday. I'm like, perfect. But then I was trying to do something around like December, and they're like, I think we can maybe squeeze you in like January 12th. I'm like, shit. We're getting a North Florida career dynasty. You made it to the Final Four. Nice. I don't know shit about North Florida, but I will always have a soft spot for it because when I first played this game, that was the team that I first did my legacy with, was North Florida. So I always kind of have a small soft spot for that because it's just like, oh man, that was the first one that got me into, like, that was the team that sucked bad enough that I spent 5 years with that got me into doing this in the first place. Kind of like I'll have a soft spot for Grambling now where it's like, you know, now I'm going into my 12th year here doing this. We're actually to 2018. We'll be pretty close to real life at this point. It took a few years, but we're going to be getting there here real soon. So, yeah, I got plenty of options to send people's way. So, I'm pretty happy about that. I just want to make sure they're not trying to put up too many crap people here. Okay, so we do have a replacement for Boobolts or Boylan and Boobolts, I think. And the center should actually, as a freshman, did I not redshirt him? Shit. That's all right. I guess, oh yeah, I only have two centers, so yeah, I could have used that. Now that I think about it, I've got two centers this time, didn't I? I think I made sure to get myself three centers for next year. No, I got a center and I got a 6'10 power forward, which in this game might as well be a center. Then I'll see how many power forwards I have when this is all said and done. All right, I'm feeling confident. We got the guys. We're pretty much set up for the end of that. We don't got to worry about any signing period because that is done. So let's go here, send through that. Advance to next season. Let's go, boys. 2 4-stars, 2 3-stars. I think it could have been better. Iowa got themselves 4 3-stars and or 3 4-stars and 1 3-star. Jesus. Yeah, I could have used a 5-star, but I think that's what next year's for. And we didn't fall too far down the list, honestly. We're not that far down the list. I think 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 30. No, 29. So we almost had a top 25 recruiting class, so that's not too bad. I had to say, it could be a lot worse. Yeah, hopefully a 5-star does it well. Okay. I know people were talking about this, about, like, the Sunday games and all that, and that I was kind of out of my mind doing this. I'm still going to pull up a calendar. I don't want to sign up any particular days. In fact, I'll probably sign up around the same days for, yeah, so if I look at 2018, let me look at 2019 real quick, and I'll see what days they have me lined up for conference games. So we have 12th, which is a Saturday, and 15th, which is a Tuesday, and then 19th, Friday, okay. So I'm thinking Fridays and Tuesdays. That'll space it out pretty nicely throughout November and December. Fridays and Tuesdays. West Virginia is the best? I guess so. Okay, so I'm just going to delete all the games right now. All right, we're going to insert the Cyclone Challenge tournament. So we'll have two games there. All right, so I think how I'm going to do this, I'm going to try to go for half home, half away. But what I'm going to do, okay, so if we do the ninth, let's move it back over here. Let's do November 16th, because the 9th and 10th will be that Friday, Saturday, and then we can come back and do a Tuesday. So yeah, let's do the 16th, and boy, who should we face for, like, a real home opener? Well, actually, you know what? We should have that Iowa game. We should have the Iowa game. Should we do home away? Yeah, we'll go to Iowa right after the Cyclone Challenge. Why not? We had two home games. We'll go there for an away game. Let's see here. Actually, I might do that. I'm gonna be at home for that. And so with the 16th, we'll move over to the 20th for, let me see here. I think what I'm going to do, the way I'm going to sort of get this out, I would like to see, oh man, is there a way to look at my own team? There should be a good way, but I think I might actually try something along these lines. If I go to Big 12. Let's say I go to Big 12. Oh, I can't. All right. I should be able to look at my own... let me see here. Okay, I can look at them. I'm trying to look at what I look like right now. I guess I won't know until I put in there. But the plan that I have is that I'm going to schedule some away games because I won't be playing the away games. I'm going to mostly focus on home games, which means if I'm going to play away, I should play some teams that might be pretty good but also won't... I won't have to worry too much about losing to them. So I think that's what I'm going to do. So we'll take someone from, like, let's say the Big East. Maybe one of the smaller teams. South Florida looks all right, but let me see here. Is there a team that everyone beats on? There's got to be a kind of a Georgetown, DePaul. DePaul seems like that would be the team. We can have a DePaul road game. We'll delete the Longwood game, and then we'll do... All right, so we'll do the 20th and then 23rd. Whoops. November 23rd, which was legitimately Black Friday. Maybe we should do the 24th just to... Nah, we'll do the 23rd. Black Friday. We'll stay out and go somewhere. And let me see here. So maybe a lesser team. I'm trying to find some... Okay, Conference USA should have some halfway okay teams, but not great teams. I'd say Memphis. I think I've played Memphis already before. Let's do Rice. Ooh, they got a good rebounding team. Rice might be it. Tulane. Tulane would probably actually be one of the better ones. UAB. I don't know. Ooh, I'm still... No. I don't need to be doing UAB. UTEP might not be too bad. Tulsa. I'm gonna go Tulane. Oh, they don't have it. Okay, I'm gonna go Tulsa then. Alright. So then we'll do one of our big games at home. So let's see, the 23rd, so we're gonna do the 27th. Who would be the big team we should play? Maybe it should be a Big East team, or we can do a Big Ten. Let's come down this way. We should probably look at SEC teams. Who's a solid SEC team to play? Auburn? I can't remember the last time I played Auburn. Georgia? Have I ever played Georgia? Away games, Grambling, home games, 2018 Duke. That's basically what I'm looking at. If I want to have a decently tough schedule, I want it to at least... Like, I'm kind of looking at teams that aren't... I'm thinking like a South Carolina. They're an 84 overall. They're not that great. And Auburn or South Carolina? Let's go. Their coach doesn't seem to be the greatest. Let's go. They were in the tournament last year. That sounds big enough. Let's do that. Let's do South Carolina. All right. Okay. I screwed things up. Okay. So we're at home against Iowa. We're away against DePaul, away against Tulsa. We come back for South Carolina. Then, let's see, we go to, let's say, the 30th. We'll face... Summit might have some decent teams. West Coast should have some decent teams. like Santa Clara, San Francisco. Yeah, let's do a better team. Let's do a much better team. You know, Mid-American's probably gonna have. They gotta have at least one or two decent teams, right? Toledo. That's about it. Okay. Let's see. Maybe Eastern, Missouri Valley. You know, we could probably. How good is Drake? Drake's a 79. That's not bad. Drake's a 79. We could do that. What's Northern Iowa look like? Northern Iowa's a 79. Let's face Northern Iowa. How about that? They always tend to. I'm a little scared just because they tend to play up to their competition. So like when they get into the tournament, that's when they just seem to like figure out how to do stuff. That seems when they figure out like, oh yeah, this is where we play basketball. Okay, so how many 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. Okay, so that's good. December, can't quite see it. Let's do December. I wanted to do Tuesday, so we're going to do 4. Let's do. Who would be another like okay? Ohio Valley, Pac-10. I don't think there's a weak Pac-10 team. Oregon might be that weak Pac-10 team. Let's try Oregon. I want to give myself at least like. Oh, I can't face Oregon. Okay, well, I guess I'm gonna go somewhere else. Southern's had some. I know with the Citadel, they at least have a. Okay, never mind. They're kind of shit right now. At least at some point in this save, they weren't shit. West Coast. No, I did West Coast. Ooh, Gonzaga. Maybe one of the. Maybe I will do that San Francisco game. Let me see here. I'll put San Francisco down for that. For an away game, and then a second away game on 6th, 7th, 8th. We'll put in. I think a Mid-American team. We didn't do a Mid-American team in the last one, did we? Great. Northern Illinois, Ohio, Toledo, like I said, is probably about the best possible one. Savage Hall, attendance 0. No one shows up. Northern Illinois wouldn't be too bad. Can I face Northern Illinois? I think Iowa State is actually. No, man, that might be Drake. I can't remember. Pretty sure Iowa State's actually facing Northern Illinois. I can't remember now. Then we need a home game. We need a couple of decent home games here. So we're gonna go to the 11th. Let's check out another Big Ten team. Illinois seems pretty good. Minnesota. Oof. I could use updated logos. Northwestern wouldn't be too bad. Penn State seems like that'd be nice. Look at their rebounding, man. Jesus. Let's do Penn State. I think I played them in a while. Let's do Penn State. We'll host Penn State. And let me see here. So with the 11th, we go to the 15th. We'll host. Should be an ACC team. Clemson would probably be a good one. We could face Duke. A still trying to get their shit together. Duke. North Carolina wouldn't be too bad. Did we lose? We lost to North Carolina, didn't we? Isn't that how it worked? God, it didn't happen that long ago, Tyler. Jesus. Let's go Duke. How about that? And then if I can put in more games here. Let me see, where am I at? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27. So yeah, I definitely still got a little bit of space left. Let's go 18. And Atlantic 10 should have somebody. Oh yeah, they got some decent enough teams here. Fordham, George Washington, LaSalle, Jesus Christ. I should face UMass. That should be a road game. I should put the Grambling game in there to sim through. We should do that. I'll do something like Richmond, St. Joseph's. I don't think I've ever faced St. Joseph's or Xavier. Let's do St. Joseph's. That sounds interesting enough. Not like I'm going to play it because we're going to be away. And then if I can put in one more game, and that'll be on the 22nd. We're going to go down to Southwest. I think it was Southwest. And, oh, God, they really shat the bed again. Damn. I'm going to feel bad about this. Rambling. I think that'll be good because I think that's 29. That UMass team is in the same state as you. Yeah, it's the same. Yeah, it's just like go back and rebuild Grambling. I probably could, but I at least want to get Iowa State like a championship. That, and I know that there's a if I look over, I don't think I can. You know what? I'm just gonna do that, sim through that, because I pretty much have the people that I want, like the people that they're gonna contact me about. I already know who it's going to be. All right. Advance to the college season. All right. Where do we sit? I think I can look at it, right? Yeah. We're in 84. That's not too bad. Our rebounds are at a 91. 84 is not bad. It's still a little bit better than we started out. And we do tend to up. Our overall 1 or 2 points over the course of the season. You know, I think we started at like an 81 at the beginning of last season, ended at like an 83, 84. So I see this coming together well for us. Yeah. So let's see here. How do we compare to some of these other teams, by the way? 86, 88, 93. 93, Jesus. 86, 92, 84, 82. Wow. Fucking Oklahoma went down fast. 81, 86, 82, 89. Wow. Kansas isn't even the premier team in the Big Ten anymore. It's all about that Texas Tech. Jesus. All right, let's take a look at the recruiting. What we got here? I can talk to them. All right, so this is what we got. This is where we're sitting. These are a lot of seniors and a couple juniors. We'll probably look at juniors here coming up in a bit. So the guy that we've been talking to, hey, howdy, hey, he's the number one recruit in the nation. So kudos. So yeah, Mr. A plus charisma fitting to go spend all of my time and effort trying to lure the number one guy over. Cause fuck yes. All right. So couple guys, I think a lot of the rest of the guys, okay. Prosper Maddox might be a bit of a wash because I think Memphis is pretty much getting him. He's a five-star. I'm going to remove him. I'm not even going to worry about it right now. Ball State might have him. So, yeah, I think Ball State's pretty much got him. I only have three scholarships anyway, so trying to thin out the crowd a little bit is going to be helpful. to what I might want. So I think we're down to four here. And these are four very doable ones because I'm in the lead in two of them. And I'm at least within the hunt in the other two. So that's what I'm working on here. But yeah, the first guy is the number one priority right now. So go ahead and grab him. Email these guys. I might actually reevaluate my juniors here in a second. I think I can pretty much get him. That's not really an issue. I'm still working on him. So yeah, I might try to find who are some guys who could potentially be leaving. I'm trying to think here. There would be juniors this year. Oh, by the way, let's take a look at this. Yeah. We don't need him. All right. So we got this. Okay, so we got a couple of guys who are red shirts. They're now back. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So we got a... Okay, we got a nice freshman here. We got a sophomore, a senior. You know what? I think with as many guys as we got, Milkowskis, we're going to... Why can't I redshirt him? Oh, he was already redshirted. That's what it was. Okay. How many shooting guards do I have? I don't have a lot of shooting guards. I can't do that. Maybe him, but he's also a three-point guy. So that's up to me if I really want to fuck with that. Let's see. There's a lot of small forwards as well. Hey. So if I move one of those small forwards to shooting guard, like let's say Shepard.
That's fine. My Elgato like almost shat itself on me.
Wow, I got a lot of Iowa guys actually. To be completely honest, I got a lot of Iowa dudes. Okay, so I'm thinking move one of these guys. I think that what I'm going to do is, even though he's a three-point shooter, I do have the 7-2 center that I want. So this dude is going to get redshirted, and I'll use him next year. And I'll have a solid three-point shooter next year. One of these small forwards needs to move to shooting guard. And I'm thinking, Jesus, we're playing big ball today, this year. Let's see. He's a freshman, redshirted sophomore. Forget Kansas, Texas Tech, Iowa State, where it's at. Hey, you never know. You know, if he's a three-point shooter, I might move Covington over to shooting guard. Although a 6'7 shooting guard doesn't sound right. 6'5 shooting guard sounds a little bit better. So I might do that. Yeah, I think I might do that. And then I actually give him a... Well, okay, because I don't want... I think I'll move him over. Because he's a solid small forward. And he's also 6'7", and I think he'll probably play a little bit better. Let's see if we move Shepard over to shooting guard. Where is he at? There we go. Move him to shooting guard. There we go. Okay, so he went down to a 77. Let's see what happens if I do it for Covington. Covington's at a 76 right now. I move him to shooting guard. Where'd he go? Okay, so not a good idea for him either. I'm thinking then that way I'll just move them back to small forward and just use them as they are. Because I don't want Shepard to be down here. There. I think they'll just put him at shooting guard anyway. So I'm okay with that. Number one prospect Iowa just did join Iowa State in the investigation. Hey, we've had some solid talents.
We've had some solid dudes. We had Royce White show up. I mean, he was okay until, you know, the whole draft thing. Until that whole NBA thing. We get some decent people. You know? I think of it more as a coach. Because, Duke is Duke because of Coach K. It's like people wanting to play for, like, the San Antonio Spurs because they got Popovich there. Like, if you want to play for the San Antonio Spurs, you're not going because you fucking love San Antonio. You're going to go because you want to play for Greg Popovich. I'm hoping that at this point I have the sort of legacy over the past 11 seasons, the sort of winning legacy that comes with the success that I've had of 295 wins and 85 losses and a two-time national champion, that they would probably want to play for me. That's my feeling. So, okay, let me look at the rotations and see if they're going there. Ah, yeah, see, that's going to... Okay, Penizzola, Hunt. Oh, see, Hunt's got it. Covington's coming off the bench. Okay, that's all right. Yeah, Covington is the sixth man. Oh, man, even as a senior. God. What if I moved him to power? I don't think he would like that, actually, especially not having Timba. You know what? Let's see if we can move Covington over to power forward, if that affects his ratings too much. All right. Yeah, we'll just leave him there, and he'll just come off the bench. That's fine. Someone will probably end up getting hurt anyway, so I won't worry about it too much. Redshirt him? Oh, I don't want to redshirt him though. I want a solid 3-point shooter who's been there for me. I could redshirt him, but Okay, how many people would I be running with right now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 guys. Yeah, I'm kind of at my minimum. I'm kind of at my minimum amount of players I'm comfortable with having. And Cox is going to be a must for... because I have enough shooting guards at this point. Cox is pretty much a must for getting redshirted. Because at least with that point, we can take one of our small forwards or one of our point guards. Because we got 4 point guards. We can move one of them over as well. In fact, that would probably be one of the better ideas, is to redshirt one of my point guards. Just take the least point guard. Take, like, one of the sophomores over here and move him over. Redshirt him. Let's go. If I do that, looking at what I got here, let's go with Penizzola. So how about that? How about if I redshirt Penizzola? Then what am I? Then I'm running with 11 people. That is not a lot of people. That is not a lot of people. But that puts... it still doesn't put Covington out there, but it does put... yeah, it does put... yeah, I literally can't do more than 11. You just utilize everyone on the team, which probably isn't too bad. Then I'd be running here. Is there a way to auto-generate rotation? Okay, so what I would have him there is Neverett moves up. Okay. That might work. That's a decent amount there. Oh man, I'm really not happy with putting Penizzola out there. I might just roll with 12. I think I'm gonna do that. I'm not gonna redshirt him. I'm gonna run with 12, and they're gonna all just have to deal with it, I think. I know they're not gonna be happy about it. I know they're not gonna be happy about it. But it gives a nice balanced rotation. And yeah, sorry to
Sorry to some of those other guys who aren't going to get their spot in there for right now. You know, McCaskis doesn't even get the time, but there's going to be people who are injured. Do I want to run with 10? Yeah, if I win, it won't matter. That's a good point. I'm really like... All right, fuck it. Let's do it. Let's redshirt Penezola. We're going to redshirt him. He'll come back next year. We'll run with what I got now. That is how we'll run with this. Okay. We'll run with that. Everyone is going to get some minutes. People are going to be happy. All right. I think we'll be fine because it's a very solid. I mean, look at this. The best guy is a 79, but the worst guy is a 70. So there's not a lot of disparity between everybody. So I think we'll be okay. And that gives us Penezola coming back next year. Probably better than ever. So he can actually lead the team after next year because I think at least one of these guys is leaving. He's a sophomore. Yeah, Neverett's going to be leaving. So Neverett takes the place this year. Penezola can come back next year, and he'll lead probably at the point guard position or shooting guard. Doesn't really matter. Yeah, we'll just do that. Hopefully this doesn't bite me in the ass, because I feel like it probably will. I did the recruiting stuff already, right? I'm just trying to make sure I got everything. Alright, I did everything here. Oh, do I want to finalize this? Oh, God. Is Tyler going to be super-de-duper silly and actually go through with redshirting his best player? Or his second best player? Am I actually going to be this sort of silly right now? Ugh. I just know there's going to be people who are like, you goddamn idiot. Alright, let me do recruiting while I mull it over in my head. Alright, I still got a clean shot at head right now. So we'll visit the recruited home. Phone and email. Get a good chance here with this guy. So the 500 records still make the NCAA tournament. That's a very good point. You know what I should look at? If I do that, I should see where I sit in the standings right now. 83. Oh, man, that really ruined my shot, too. All right, you know what? People are just going to have to be pissy about this. I'm not going to... Let's remove the red shirt. They're just gonna have to deal with being on the bench if they want. I need to have my people there. Sorry, buddies. That's all right. That's okay. I really wanna have a little bit of success. I don't wanna completely crap on everything here. There we go. Okay. While I'm at it, if they wanted to play, they had to go to Grambling. Yeah, let's do that. And then I think I can maybe look at, okay, who are my juniors? That's going to be the one, too. Who are my juniors? Whoops. I don't have any juniors. So, cool, I guess. I only have three people leaving. And they're not even my three best guys either. They're three solid guys, but they're not my three best guys. So, I'm kind of happy about that. But in 3 years, though, I'm fucked. Hopefully, I'll have people take over at that point. All right, so I did all that. There's not really hardly anybody to... Oh, wait, no. Okay. So
Yeah, as far as juniors go, I don't know if I have many. I'll worry about it a little bit later then. 3 years I'll be back at Grambling. I probably won't be back at Grambling out of it, I gotta be honest. I still wanna be at Iowa State. I wanna get that I made my adjustments already. I'm gonna live with it. I'm gonna live with my team. Some people aren't gonna get all the minutes that they want, but that's life. I'm falling behind. Invite them to there. Give them that. There you go. Call them. You guys email them. I'm starting to. Here, I need to offer the scholarships. I got him. I maybe got him. To be fair, I do have a four-star. I do have a four-star guy that'll make up for the potential loss of the number one guy. But I'm still gonna go full bore into it right now. Until I end up failing that. So so we'll see what happens. But I'm at least gonna go all hands on deck to try to make this happen and see what I can make happen here. Alright. Prairie View. Jesus Christ. How long has it been since... Was Prairie View in one of my... Where are they at? So, yeah, that's right. We have faced Prairie View. Because that's where we were in... Man, it's been years since we've seen them. Who's in our bracket, by the way? I'd like to see. It's Prairie View, Jacksonville, NC Central. Okay, so we're just going to blow through these two games. Lickety-split. You're basically harassing him at this point. I don't care. You need money? We can't give you money, but we can give you bitches. Oh, there's going to be someone upset about that. What have you missed? You missed basically just off-season recruiting. The three guys that I had who are seniors, that's who I've got, and I'm basically harassing new high school seniors now to join my team. So that's where I'm at now. And by the way, because it is the Cyclone Challenge, let me do a little bit of the studio mode here, because guess what? It's time for the return of the ticker. Home streak ticker. We are at a current record of 25-4. I did lose my last home game, so it's time to start building up a little bit of a streak here. And let's get rolling on a couple of these games here. See what we got going on. Get two boxes of Cheez-Its plus four boxes of Capri Sun for $5.23. Hang on.
Go up against the Iowa State Cyclones. Welcome, college basketball fans.
Hang on.
Semifinal matchup. We're here.
Oh, I got to sign up for a trial. Well, I don't want to do that.
And our sideline reporter Tracy Wolfson, give us your take, Bill. There's a terrific matchup at the small forward position. Shepherd is on
all those halls
were
all the same.
Forwards in the nation. He's quite
yeah,
a
I
got to
admit, this is well, this is kind of a this is not how I can confirm that this is not how this is not how Hilton Coliseum looks.
Watch how this fella
I can confirm at least that. Oh god, this is going to be this is loud, isn't it? Hang on. I'm at least going to turn it down to like a 5. All right, let's see how things work here. It would be, yeah, see, that's the thing, is it would be really nice to see how this all would look in the news. Okay, let's see what we got.
Ah,
probably not that full. You know, for a, I mean, the team's doing okay. But yeah, there's a lot of very, like invested people. It was actually kind of interesting because for a throwaway, I wouldn't say throwaway, but for a game that we pretty much, you could pretty much tell because they were facing Omaha, which I actually had to look up. I didn't even realize they were in the MAC. I thought maybe they were like a Division II team. I'm like, oh shit, there's an Omaha team in MAC. When the fuck did that happen?
Let's it go.
snatched inside by Scruggy. So, yeah, and it was still probably good half full. I'd say it was probably, or, you know, maybe like 3/8 full. Like, if it wasn't half full, it was close. There you go. We got ourselves a new cheesy center. Our team is a Ritz cracker.
Takes the shot. The three-pointer was offline by Garrison.
The big fella with a tough rebound. No denying him on that one.
Backs in. Scruggy goes up. Clinton.
Oh, you whore. The third member of our team, you Tracy whore.
Wilson. Tracy? Just before the game, I talked with Coach Wilson.
Yeah, I got to say, like, getting close to finals on a game that's not really a huge game, you still nearly half full crowd. I fell out of place because I didn't wear any of my Iowa State stuff. And I was even in the 200s, it was full of people that was like everybody was wearing Iowa State stuff. Mostly because I think that's kind of the crowd of people who would go to even the most mundane of games like that. That wasn't a good idea.
Gorgeous pass. Gordon has it right wing.
Oh yeah, and I did put it on my Twitter. I did say it's like, yo, the way I kind of sort of play sometimes, it's kind of like how it's kind of like how they actually play.
And kept himself between his man and the hoop. Goes up. Monster stuff by Scruggy.
There you go. Except they don't have a cheesy 7-2 center that they can just spam post moves with.
Gets it. High post.
Preseason college game. I didn't even know that the they did preseason college games. I got to be honest.
Misses the tying basket. About 9.5 minutes left in the half.
Hunt. Yeah, I guess it kind of makes sense. But yeah, I was like, okay.
Backs him down. Beats it to the left wing. From 20 feet out. All net on the shot.
There you go.
They push their lead to 5.
Local school versus Duke, or more precisely, a bunch of white dudes versus Duke.
Risky pass. Garrison goes up, blows up off the glass.
I love the defense. I gotta tell you, I'm feeling that high rebound rating here.
Hunt misses the long.
Damn.
They're still up by 5. Passes it to the wing.
Shit.
Kimba
Shit.
Pulls it in.
Got it. Don't worry.
Still a double digit game.
Don't worry, they're just missing everything, boys.
Passes back, right side, with the shot. Three-pointer by Shepard.
There you go. There you go. Look at that. Yeah, these games, I'm not even going to do, like, most of the adjustments. Like, I'm going to win these games quickly. I imagine once they actually get into conference play, though, with, like, there's no way there would be purple. Like, the Prairie View, like, even though this seems like neutral ground, there's no way that the arena would be half purple of people going, you know, Prairie View just coming here to support the team. Like, nah. The arena would be about half full, and it'd be all red. It'd just be red everywhere. Maybe some gold.
Shepard. Drops. He's 2 for 2 from long range.
All the threes. Like I said, I even felt I'm a big Iowa State fan. I should have even worn my hat. I can't kind of came from work, so I didn't do much changing. But yeah, the fact that I wasn't wearing Iowa State gear, decked out head to toe in any of it, I felt out of place. I don't think there's that much purple at home Purdue games. There we go.
The Cyclones with a chance for a double-digit lead.
Well, you can't afford to spot the other team any more points, Vern. They're in danger of letting this game be over before the second half.
Nope. Top of the key. Unloads.
Now they just let him wide open. Oh, damn it.
But they're still out in front.
We got some shooters, though.
That's good. We got kind of the inside out concept of having some inside guys who can pop it out to some good shooters on the outside.
Kemp,
I don't know if that's an actual philosophy.
Misses the three.
Is that is there a
still down nine.
I feel like there probably is. I'm going to call it the inside out philosophy. Big forwards, a big power forward and center who can kick it out to three guys. Small forward and the two guards who can pop it up in three.
Covington inbounds the ball. Shepherd dumps it off. Hits it.
There you go.
The Prairie View coach saw something out there he didn't like, and he called for a timeout. He wants to make sure that everyone is...
let's do a point of emphasis for... Let's do shot selection. I think
like
it's the only thing that we might be able to improve on. Like, defense is fine. Rebounding has been more than okay. I guess ball handling, we haven't lost the ball yet.
There's
so.
No question what kind of defense they're in.
It's literally called inside out philosophy. Oh, wow.
Bounce back.
I don't know what
Left
to say
side.
To that other than,
backs
like,
down.
Oh, that's good. Like, hey, that's cool.
Iowa State with the ball. They're on a 16-5 run, and it's gathered up by Garrison.
I guess someone far more original than I did way before I ever was born, most likely.
Iowa State.
You can't do that.
Both teams are going to shake things up a little.
They have a lot of chance at the basketball games. I do got to say the difference. I think having a school band there really tends to help the idea of
inbounds the ball. It's a 9-point
really
spread.
Tends to help the idea of making Sparky. It a bit more fun.
Backs in to the rim. Great finish in traffic.
Hey.
He's got seven. Has it down low.
Poor fundamental coaching style. Collapse the defense,
and
send out your shooters. Yeah, I mean, I knew there was kind of a philosophy. I just didn't know if there was a name for it. And usually, I don't know if it technically goes out to... Really? Okay, well, at least we had good enough defense for that. I didn't know if it all generally also included maybe the small forward. Because I think the small forward might be one of my best three-point shooters on the team. Not that it was showcased right there. That's a long two. You still miss the long two. What are you doing?
Right wing shoots it.
Shows what I know about basketball. How much basketball have I played on this channel and I didn't know there was an inside-out philosophy?
Dishes it to the high post.
You wouldn't even know I knew what a pick and roll was if you watched enough of these games.
Scrucky has it middle. Dish left wing, Covington.
Come on, you got it this time. There you go.
They're leading 21-12.
We're just over a week from Smash Brothers. That should be fun. I'm considering. I don't know how I'm going to do it. Hey, DeVore, what's up? I don't know if I'm going to do it or not, but I'm highly considering because I have it pre-ordered on Best Buy. But I'm thinking about just maybe moving it to something else. I don't know what the something else is going to be. They're just leaving him open, and he's not. They're not hitting. Thinking about just like maybe moving it to some other game or using it to buy it another game and buying Smash Brothers on the Japan eShop. Because, wow. Because the Japan eShop, assuming that Smash Brothers releases at midnight in Japan, that would be 9 a.m. Central, 10 a.m. Eastern, 9 a.m. Central Thursday. And I have next Thursday off as one of my, you know, scheduled days off. I could spend a good chunk of time on Thursday playing the game if I were so inclined.
He gets them both.
The only thing would be having to pay that slight premium to play Asia to try to get enough money to put on my eShop account. Because I think I only have about $5 right now.
Covington beats it to the right wing.
I don't even think I have the $5 anymore. I think I spent it. I think they came out with some. I think they came out with some DLC tracks for Tycho. Tycho Drum Master. And I think I did that.
It was too late when he realized he was on the line. You've got to be a little more heads up, Vern.
What you doing? What you doing?
Kimba inbounds the ball. Out left.
I nearly got a 5-second call because I was too busy petting my roommate's cat.
Hauls in the board.
Fuck.
Look at the big fella pull down that board. When he sees the ball go up, he isn't afraid to go after it.
Kemp hands it off. Clinton.
Ah, only down by 5. Come on. All right, I need a slightly different strategy than chucking threes. I think that's my new thing here. Let's actually try the occasional pick and roll. Oh shit! Oh, I was hoping for a foul. That's all right.
Backs down. Double clutches. Can't get the.
Oh, Timba, what are you doing?
Still out in front by 5.
I was trying to get in front of him. Really be a pain in the ass.
Kemp launches one from beyond the arc. Timba yanks it down inside.
What a good job on the defense to make him think about.
Hey, Jesus, look at the vertical on that dude. Oh yeah, maybe piranha plant. They were talking about what type of character. My friends actually just last night were talking about what type of characters they maybe wanted to main. And I don't know yet. If I don't try to main Piranha Plant or continue my maining of Pac-Man, I was pretty good with, and then I did pretty well with Duck Hunt Dog. So if I don't main either of those, I might try Isabelle.
Milton keeps it alive on the offensive end. Flip up and in on that last layup. Milton lowered the boom. Look at the big fella.
I think Isabelle might be pretty good. I've seen some stuff from her that. I'd be like, yeah, you know what? That's not too bad.
Pass, top of the key. Kemp. Gets it. High post. Garrison raises up. The three won't fall.
Ah, there we go.
Wasn't too worried about.
But yeah, dude, if I can get Smash, if I can make that actually happen on my Switch, oh, damn it. I might actually stream Thursday, just Smash.
It's blocked. And it's out of bounds. Last touch by Prairie.
Oh, who was it? Hey.
Both teams are making substitutions.
If I'm not stuck with Wii Fit Trainer. I did pretty okay with Wii Fit Trainer. But yeah, I think as far as my goofier mains go, I think Pac-Man was probably my probably one of my best. I really enjoyed Pac-Man.
Being a spaz.
I don't know what this cat. This cat gets on some stupid shit and she just goes ballistic over it.
Hey, and they're now behind by 8. 59 seconds left in the first half. Passes to the free throw line. Scrocky.
Scrocky.
It falls short.
Oh, come on.
8-point lead.
They can go 2-for-1 here, Vern, if they hurry it up.
Dishes to the right.
I'm guessing the World of Light thing is going to be, because there's a lot of assumptions about perhaps how you unlock characters.
Shoots it.
And I'm thinking that, you know, the story mode, that World of Light mode might be, you know, the thing that gets you your new characters. God damn it.
But they still lead by 8.
So I might just play the shit out of that on the first day or two.
Monsures. Milton snatches the rebound. Shepard with the shot. Misses the buzzer beater.
Okay. That was a little bit more disappointing than I'd like it to have been. I'd like to have been leading a hell block.
How about the habit in the first half, Bill?
If we don't see some improvement soon, this could
41% is not good. 5-for-12 is pretty okay, though.
Oh, the fuck?
I finally figured out what the cat was fucking with.
It's one of those, you know, on a soda bottle, they have the cap and then they have the little thing on the cap underneath of it that kind of helps seal the whole thing. That's what she's playing with. I don't know how that ended up somewhere underneath my chair, but she just became obsessed with digging it out. So I realized why she was spazzing, that little bitty plastic thing. She's just going fucking nuts for it. Shit. There you go. Imagine you start the game, you only have Kirby. I mean, I wouldn't be mad about that, but it sounds like you're at least starting with the original 8.
Back to you.
All right, Tracy. We'll see if they can do that. Kemp, lead pass inside.
Damn, can we not play down to our competition today? Please and thank you. Can we not just poop ourselves? This is not boding well. Hopefully this is just a little bit of, like, not like, meshing. Like, just some first game, like, trying to mesh with each other.
Gets them both. Kimba inbounds the ball. Peñazola hands it off.
Right, what do we got? There we go. Oh, I thought for a second he might not have made that.
Feeds it to the right wing.
Got it.
That's his fifth rebound
yeah,
in this
having
one.
Jesus.
That kind of shot, it's just going to hurt
my
your
roommate's
offense.
Playing Rocket League.
Shepherd catches it.
So I'm
left
just hearing,
wing.
Nice! From the other room.
It in. But they're still up by 8. Kemp.
He's become obsessed with Rocket League. It's weird. I guess it's not weird, but yeah, it's just like, I don't know. I didn't think he was going to be. I think he's a big competitive gamer. That's his thing.
When you keep that pressure
you can't
on.
Really play anything unless it's, like, competitive
Hunt
in some way.
Backs down.
Unless you're, like,
unload.
Physically competing against people. Fuck!
By Scruggy. Still a 6-point lead. Can't convert. He'll go to the line for 2.
Second. Gets it, yeah. I don't know what it is. This is not Fortnite. Well, I mean, he used to play Fortnite. You know, as long as we still get the win, that's fine, I guess. I would have liked to get this done sooner, though.
That's got to be frustrating. They desperately need to narrow the gap.
Not what I wanted.
They come away
okay.
Empty.
I don't remember him dribbling. How come I couldn't move with him? Oh, that time he dribbled. I'm trying to get them, like, away. Just kind of move. Oh, no, that's not what I wanted. Okay, I'll take it. I was trying to pump fake. I was going to do one more pump fake and then just put it in the paint with one of the big guys. But, yeah, that didn't happen.
Passage to the elbow. Shakur shoots a 3. Milton gets the board inside. That's exactly the shot they want him taking, Vern. Shepherd.
I don't know why you were standing so far back. Oh, I hate you. There you go. At least you got it back again.
He just keeps coming at you in a multitude of ways. The Prairie View coach saw something out there and he wants to make some adjustments.
All right. Yep. Well, let's keep going with the shot selection. We could use it. I probably at least get these two games done. Like, get the Cyclone Challenge done, and then the next. I guess it depends on the. Oh, shit. I was busy fiddling with my controller cord. Oh, shit! I guess it depends on how quickly I can get done the next game, and how quickly I can just kick their ass on this game. I could do the Iowa game. We'll see.
Clinton passes down low. Iowa State has had serious problems with their interior defense. And Tracy has a report from their bench.
Coach Wilson was talking to him just a second ago about that very problem. He said he wants to collapse their defense.
Oh, shit. Look at the point guard with the block.
Amazing to see a guard get his hand on so
many attempts. There you go. Oh, Jesus Christ.
This guy has plenty of
he threw that fucker down. You like your anime night? I don't blame you. Have fun. I just had mine earlier, so.
Back left side. Milton,
all right, what do we got behind over here? Shepherd. There you go. All right, now we're firing. I'm liking this.
Both teams will make some substitutions.
Hey, here comes Cheesy.
Jordan inbounds the ball. Shakur.
Hey, what the fuck?
Kemp.
I don't know if he got knocked down to the ground or if he flopped. I don't think there was flopping in this game. I can do that, though. Just kind of get him stuck.
Kemp shoots. Garrison corrals the miss.
Ah, damn it. I'm just going to stand right here. Oh, nope. Ah, you had every chance to make that happen, and you still failed.
Just a little bit harder. Backs him down.
Oh, no. You know, it's okay. Never mind.
And had the ball knocked loose. That's why he's squeezing, young fella. But they're still down.
All right, Timba. Let's see what you got here.
Timba with the hook shot. Gets it to go.
Oh, my God. Fuck your defense. Oh. Fuck your offense, too. Good. Another three-pointer, and we can probably just call this one done.
The Panthers will retain possession.
Damn. Close. Cat, if you get into some shit, I'm going to kick your ass.
Gordon inbounds the ball. Beats it cross court. Kemp takes the shot.
Nope.
Off target from downtown. Prairie View is having big problems.
He's so into his game.
And I think Tracy has something for us on that.
Oh! Damn! All right, that's 20. Holy shit. I'll take it. Fuck it. All right, NC Central. I think I've played these guys a couple of times. I kind of remember their shitty logo. Right. While that gets ready to load, the streak moves to 1, and the home record moves up to 26-4. Ugh. All right. at least it does a little bit. That unity really needs to go up. We lost a lot of our best guys. All right.
It's time for College Hoops on 2K Sports. The away team square up against the Iowa State Cyclones. Welcome aboard, everyone, as we get ready to bring you the tournament's championship game. We're here at Hilton Coliseum. I'm Vern Lundquist, here with Bill Raftery and Tracy Wolfson.
There we go.
What do you think, Bill?
Cool. I am ready.
The Cyclones control the open.
Bing, bang, boom. Let's go.
The game has just begun, and they're already
nope.
in the...
Screw it. He'll just do it anyway. Oh, no. What? Come on. There you go. Timba will help.
And they now go up by 2. Beats it down low.
Hey, Dirty Duck. What's up? Oh, shit. Yeah, it has been a while.
Sprocky.
Yeah, you don't want to leave them open like that. There you go. There you go. Go. Just put it up. It's fine. You're 7-2. Fuck it.
Carota inbounds the ball.
Come on. Come on.
Passes it to the free throw line. Forgus with the shot.
By the way, the fact that I changed kind of how the resolution looks seemed to mess with the size of the ticker. I feel like I could actually make the ticker a little bigger now.
Vern, earlier today I talked with Coach Wilson. He told me that the speed of the
So it might have actually been very helpful to have done that, because now I can maybe make I don't think I need to make it any bigger, but I could.
Be shooting layups on us all game.
Thank you, Tracy. Takes it up.
Yeah, because the way it originally was, is pretty much it lined up to the bottom of the scoreboard. I forget why I changed the size of it. I think it might have been because of my probably my PlayStation TV or something. I think that was the fucky one. I think the Switch was fine. Yeah, I started adding that after last season sometime. I think maybe towards the middle of it, or maybe even the beginning of it. Yeah, but sometime last season I added the ticker because I wanted to keep track of my my home record, because that's what I'd like to be proud of here. I'm playing like all my home games. I think that's pretty much just what I'm down to now, is just home games. Instead of doing like conference, you know, all my conference games, and or at least just my home conference games and all my non-conference, I scheduled it in a way to hopefully we'll win a good chunk of our non-conference games that I don't play that are on the road. Everything else I'll do. Yeah, late to streaming, super late. Yeah, I get to be a daywalker now. It's weird. Ah, you suck. I say that, but we should probably like put our foot on the gas pedal a little bit here. Hunt launches one from beyond the arc. Ah, come on. No, what are you doing? Oh, our inside guys are just pooping their pants. There you go.
I love the strength. He fought through the foul, no problem. And that'll give him the 3-point chance.
I'll take that. That's good. That's good.
Backs on the free throw for the 3-point play.
Ah, oh, almost had it.
Martinez tosses it up court.
I do gotta say, Hilton does have like those tunnel things there. I don't know so much about the middle one, but I know that the when
right
they
side.
Open the doors, they have the tunnels Martinez. For that on the sides there. But yeah, they've at least updated a little bit to have like I think that's like a staple of every arena now, is you have to have that you have to have that little banner ticker thing. I feel like that's a staple of every modern one, is you got to have that little ticker tape banner, usually separating your 100 and 200 sections. And if you're super rich, you're doing it separating the 2 and 300.
Hunt dumps it off, rises and
nah, there you go, there you go. Oh, that worked? That worked.
And they lead by two.
Why is it so... Why is it such a hyper-competitive game right now, by the way? I wasn't expecting it to be this hyper-competitive right now.
Pulls the trigger. The 10-footer was
we're missing and they're missing, and it's but everyone's like making some decent shots at least.
Outright backs him down.
Just do it. Just do it. There you go. What's been going on lately? You know, not much. I guess you could see on my YouTube channel, I've just been doing this, continuing with the Iowa, sure doing Iowa State stuff here. TEW, I just did, at least on stream, I did my blackout event. That was pretty crazy. That was a lot of emotions, I think, were had in the chat. For my actual pay-per-view event. Other than that, I haven't, like, I went from 2K18 to 2K19, redid XBA. I feel like I'm going to stick with 2K19 for a little while, because the My League, like, rule changes that they allow you to do in NBA 2K19 is crazy. Like, I love it. Like, I think I got through my first season, and there were proposed rule changes that you could actually, like, push through.
Dish, left wing.
And I think I did, like, move the... I dealt with mostly, like, kind of the actual gameplay part of it. But I think it was, like, move the shot clock down to 20 seconds. You have 6 seconds to get across half court.
Kimba backs down.
Oh, shit.
Releases from
16. Do it up. There you go. You have 6 seconds to get across half court. 20-second shot clock. Three in the key is now five in the key, so you can get 5 seconds in the paint here. And then sudden death overtime. If it goes to overtime, it's a sudden death overtime where the first basket wins. I'm imagining there's going to be a mountain of salt in my future. At some point, I'm going to make some miracle shot and be like, I made it to overtime! And then they just, like, get the tip and it goes, boop, in. You can actually customize. Well, they have a large chunk of rules that you can choose from. And in the new My League, you can't, like, they made it so it isn't just when rules come up, you can accept or reject them. You can actually change which rules come up and then force accept them. So, like, that way, if you're doing a My League where you want to play specific rules, you don't have to like, have teams, like, kind of, sort of, you know, try to accept it. You can just, like, yeah, these are some new rules that are going on. And they have a good litany of them for contracts and trades and gameplay and how playoffs work and how all-star games work. And, yeah, I think it'll probably take me about 4 seasons to get all the changes that I want implemented. But it's, yeah, sudden death overtime in basketball. That is... I saw that. I'm like, that's crazy and kind of stupid, but I want it because why not? That's just the, if I'm doing the XBA, we need just that kind of stupid shit in there. It's not enough to just have it kind of sort of be like at the NBA. Like, it's gotta be ridiculous. First one to hit a shot from beyond half. That's what it should be. First one to foul loses. Oh, yeah, that was another thing. You can turn off foul outs, or you can change it to, like, 5 or 7. Where it's like, yeah, you can either... Oh, automatic free throws. That was another thing I'm thinking about implementing, too. Where if you foul someone and they would take 2 shots, they just automatically get the points. I'm thinking about that. That would kind of eliminate the hack-a-shack strategy, which absolutely the AI does in certain situations. God damn it. I actually seen that in 2K19. There was one game where they actually employed a hack-a-shack strategy on my center, and he had like a 45 free throw shooting and still drained both of them somehow. It was crazy. It'd be even crazier if I actually won in overtime. But yeah, you can take out the fouling out just to be like, yeah, you never foul out. Oh my God. Suck it. Quidditch rules, first one to hit a shot from half court with a lead. Game doesn't end until it happens. There's just a golden snitch, or like a basketball version of a golden snitch. It's just an actual snitch. It's just some dude who snitched, like, ratted on his friends to the FBI for drug paraphernalia or drug possession. He's just running around, and they gotta have one of the guys on the court catch him. Let's continue our shot selection. I feel like that's the thing. This could get, yeah. Oh, it's going to get stupid real quick.
Inbounds the ball.
Automatic points, sudden death overtime. Might even take out the fouling outs. Just like, fuck it. Why not? So that basically, it doesn't even matter to try to do late game fouling. That would be another thing, because if you think about it, that affects a lot of things. That isn't just affecting like a hack-a-shack strategy. That affects all late game strategy, because the intentional fouls pretty much mean dick at that point. Oh, I thought you had it. He was so open. Late game fouling would mean like jack shit at that point, because if you got guaranteed points, like, oh.
Turn this one over.
Yeah, that'd be crazy.
These guys are having trouble with fundamental team play, Vern. As that turnover shows you, they don't have much in the way of chemistry at
the first one to trip an opposing player, a technical foul. I thought for a second it was going to say first one to trip an opposing player wins, and it was like, all right, going to go sign Zaza. First one to trip an opposing player. All right, I'm going to go grab Zaza Pachulia and Grayson Allen, and we're going to win this every single time. Damn.
Shepherd inbounds the ball right around 3 minutes left in the half.
There you go. Gets the finger roll to fall. He's got every four. Foul should be three shots below 2 minutes. That would be pretty dope too. Some way to kind of like take out, like, I hate the ruining of the flow of the game with all that late game fouling. I get it, but fuck. Yeah, having the automatic free throws is one thing I'll probably do next season in that, just because it's like, oh man, dude, that pretty much eliminates that garbage right there. Like, you got to either steal the ball or force them to do something they don't want to. First kick in the dick wins, signs Draymond Green. Grayson Allen roll. First one to dunk another person's testicles.
Inside.
First one to stick their ass out and, like, first one to tackle an opposing player with their ass wins.
The student section sounds pretty excited for her. I think they like what they're seeing. Oh,
I wonder if Grayson Allen's going to get his shit kicked in once. I think it almost happened in a preseason. I remember seeing a video where it almost happened in a preseason game. I wonder if he's going to, like, chill out on that, or if or if he's just going to get his ass kicked in a game. He's going to do it to the wrong dude, and it's not going to be pretty for him. I'm kind of surprised that, like, Utah signed him. Then again, he's a pasty white dude, so it actually does make sense that it was Utah that signed him. They need their next pasty white dude who can, you know, do extremely well for them. And then go fuck off elsewhere. I'm still saying shot selection.
Shepherd inbounds the ball. Pena's
so
Zola brings it up.
Fucking Rocket League. Strucky, I don't know why. Down. It just kills me.
Goes up,
I like how the dude didn't even attempt to try to block that. He's like, you know what? Fuck this. I ain't getting a fucking poster.
Passes. Top of the
kid
key.
Waiting in the wings, yeah.
Goes up.
Just some illegitimate Ron Artest kid. I hope he at least goes. If that happens, I at least hope the kid goes by Artest. Nothing would be stupider than, like, David World Peace.
You just hope it doesn't wreck his confidence. It's hard to see how it would.
They ain't even trying to try to. They're just trying to stay out of the way. Love the fact that I at least cracked open my door. Just hear my roommate, put that in. Put it in.
Right wing, knocked loose, and it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Iowa State.
Hey, you're playing Rocket League, right? Not like watching a porno?
Rose inbounds the ball. Shot clock dwindling.
Oh, shit.
The shot by Andrews. But they're still behind by 11.
I didn't think you heard me. It's all right. Joey World Peace.
It'd be better if he really did have, like, just the lamest name.
We're ready to begin the second half.
Like a second-generation basketball talent, Bob World Peace. Yeah, that's what I asked him. Well, because he was screaming at it, I could hear him down the hallway screaming at his screen, "Put that in! Put that in!" And I was like, he's playing Rocket League, right?
Let's send it down to Tracy Wilson.
During halftime, I talked with Coach Wilson. He felt it wouldn't be
damn it. That would have been sweet. Don World Peace.
Coach said that even though his starters had plenty of energy, he would still
Ron Artest would be the first to deck out. Oh, my God. There wouldn't even be, like, a rivalry there. Different looks on offense. Like, at least with, like, the Artest-Ben Wallace thing, it was, like, two volatile dudes who ended up coming together in a rage. Ron Artest and, like, Grayson Allen would just be, he does some dirty shit, and then Ron Artest just decks him. And that's it. What the fuck was that? That was the most half-assed attempt at a shot I've ever seen. I didn't even want him to do that.
Andrew inbounds the ball. Sprucky pulls it in off the glass. That's not a shot you expected.
God, I wish there
miss.
Was a new college hoops. Why can't people be so invested in a college basketball game like they Sprucky do a college football game?
Wing, takes the shot.
Can we get hardwood champions? Maybe by some people who actually know how to program video games, so I don't have to sit here and impatiently wait for the next 2 years to see if a college football game comes out that's probably going to be mediocre anyway, because it's going to be done by an Australian studio that does mediocre video games.
He's 2 for 3 for the game. Catches it on the inside. Sprucky takes it up.
The fuck? Did I just see that? College hockey game would be nice, too. I want to see what the fuck just happened. Okay, so we did spin. I feel like there's a... Whoa. Okay, so he didn't... Is that considered a dribble, or what the fuck is that? I think he just like broke the space-time continuum to make that shot.
Tremendous pass by Timbo. Two assists, and he
leads his team in that category. Out really good. I mean, I hope so too. I don't want to be a Debbie Downer about that.
These guys are having serious trouble.
It's just I know Big Ant's making it, and I know it'll at least look decent. But yeah, like the Big Ant Studios games are like,
Hunt passes to the left wing.
I mean, at least they know how to make a sports game, so at least it should be like doable. Suck it! Come on, do it again.
They're bringing the double team. Martinez
here, I'm just gonna do this now. Oh no, that worked out really poorly. 2K. Okay, so like 2K. 2K does like okay. The difference between 2K would be nice to try to do that. But okay, mediocre game. I feel like a lot of the things that people really crap on NBA 2K about has a lot to do with their my career and their microtransactions. Their actual on-court gameplay is pretty solid. In fact, it's extremely solid. There's a reason why it's still one of the most purchased games. You know, it's the like one of the most like purchased sports games every year. Because if you play my league, you don't really see a lot of that horse shit that comes into play with, like, my career and my team and all that. Like, I stopped playing my team, I think, by, like, 2K13. I was like, you know what? This is shit. this isn't as fun of a game mode as I hoped it would be. Big Ant Games is kind of shady. I was kind of wondering, like, is there anything else besides the fact they kind of make mediocre games and they recycle the majority of the music that they use? Out of bounds. Touch last. Oh, dude, he just took out one of his teammates doing that. I know it isn't going to react, but I really wish if this was like 2018 coding, you know, someone would have just ate shit on that one. Ugh. I want to see where that was going. Oh, that legit was just, if there wasn't a wall there, that was either going right at his head. That was either going right at that dude's head or it was going to hit someone in the front row. Madden mod on PC. I haven't. I need to. Hunt, it's blocked. Shoots. One of the big channels I like to watch hasn't really covered. Like, he's covered a lot of Madden, but he hasn't really covered other shit. Which, yeah, I get it. Madden's going to get you the views. No one. Axis Football 18 isn't going to get you nearly as many views as you would, as one would hope. If you've got the timeouts, you might as well use them. You can't take them to the bank. Let's continue our shot selection thing. I think I'll be simming it here pretty soon. I might as well. I could do it pretty much now. I know I'm an hour and a half in. I might just make it this. This might just be it for me because I would like to go to bed at some point.
Martinez.
Still, like, hearing him out there.
Beats it to the right side.
Oh, shit.
Good look.
Ah, damn it.
14 points, and he's his team's leading scorer.
There you go, there you go, there you go, there you go, there you go. Oh!
The away team may have made some changes.
Maybe we'll do 18. I know 20 is usually the big one, but I might do it at like 18 here. Once again, I just like to make sure we have enough momentum going our way that I don't have to worry about somehow just having the whole team collapse in the last several minutes.
Feeds left wing. Martinez.
Yep.
Releases. Carota gets the board inside.
Really? Really?
There's no question what kind of defense they're in, Vern. Miniman.
Man-to-man.
Passes to the right. Right side. Milton with the floater. Rose.
Milton.
Still have a 14-point lead. Skips it to the left block.
Yeah, I need to see. Because I've seen some of the college mods for Madden on PC. I've just been kind of leaving it alone for the last couple of months because I'm like, I didn't enjoy it as much as I thought I would.
Not there on the three.
Oh, God damn it.
They're still up by 14. Uses the crossover. Rose catches it on the elbow.
Yeah, we'll see. I should see. I've seen, like I said, I've seen some of the NCAA ones. I don't know if they've changed other things about it.
No good on the last layup by Hunt.
Holy shit. Make a basket.
Credit to D there. They reacted quickly enough to throw him off.
Lid off hoop now, please. There you go. Suck it.
Tons of steals for a big man. He's got quick hands, reads the situation, which allows him the opportunity to catch the ball cleanly. That's a big asset.
Most of the stadium in Jersey's done cool. Done a great amount. Oh, that's cool.
Rose inbounds the ball. The away team is really struggling.
Do they do any? I don't know if they do. Do they have any like scoreboards? Because that's one of the things I always like about the NBA 2K series is when they make like a litany of scoreboards. I don't know if people have done anything with that yet.
Never beats it to the right side.
Just put it in. Just put it in. You're good. You're 7-2.
He's got 18.
Using last season's rosters.
And Tracy is near their bench. Tracy?
The head coach looked downright disgusted after that last turnover led to yet another opposition bucket. He yelled three simple words at his guys on the floor. Protect the ball.
All right. Wow. Damn it.
from 18 feet away. That's a long two, but I'll take it. Come the fuck on. There you go. Goaltend that shit. All right. I feel like up by, what was it, 18? Here. Yeah, I think we're good. I think we're good at this point. Yeah, there you go. It's the same Madden scoreboard. Okay. I'm a big fan of scoreboard mods. I don't know why. I just enjoy it. All right. Home record now goes up to 27-4. Oops. Oh, my God. Slide up, please. Thank you. Two. Ah, shit. There we go. All right, 27-4, streak of two. There we go. All right, let's see a new week of recruiting. What do we got here? Shit, that's all right. Should I just consider it a wash at this point? Like, he's going to go to North Carolina or Kentucky. If I still can't make it up at this point, like, he's going to sign with them. You know what? Let me look at the other point guard here. I think I pretty much have this. Okay. So this dude, okay, I pretty much have him. So I guess I'll go. Oh, man. Okay. I don't want to lose some of the guys that I've had. So let me look at some of these other guys. Okay. So these are all world guys. So it's not exactly time I'm taking away from them. So I might as well just go and do that as well and just try, because there's not much else. Yeah, it's not like I'm taking away that time from them. I should be able to get these guys. That shouldn't be an issue. So I can still go full bore into this dude and try. I don't feel well about it, but it's at least worth a shot. Scoreboard mods wouldn't show the time. The only scoreboard mods I've seen for NCAA football was someone literally like photoshopping it over the scoreboard. Those are really the only ones I've seen where it was like, oh, this isn't actually a mod. I think someone just put video. They just put a graphic over the video. That's what it looked like. But you might have seen something that I didn't see. Whereas, like, that looks cool, but I can also clearly tell that someone just kind of put an overlay over what you got right now. Yeah. Fuck it. You know what? Let's do the Iowa game. Let's do the Iowa game, because I'm only going to do this tonight, I think. So I might as well just make it a little over 2 hours and just have this done. And so we can bask in our games here. Because, yeah, if we get this done, we're actually going to have a road stretch. And then we'll have South Carolina at home for the next one. So we get this done, we can go through a couple more weeks. We'll be solid. So, yeah, let's do it. Iowa versus Iowa State to end this. 86. So they're a little bit better than us, but that's fine. Their team unity is... Ooh. All right. What's my reaction to LSU? My reaction is I don't know what the fuck you're talking about. What happened in said game? On 2K Sports. The Iowa Hawkeyes go up against... Who's the best recruit this year? The dude that is the five-star recruit that I'm looking at. I've been talking to him since he was a junior. But seven overtimes? Jesus. What do you think, Bill? Yeah, whoever that the five-star dude that I'm going after, Lance Head is his name. He's the number one guy right now. He's a point guard, which is fine because I got another point guard, four-star, that I should be able to get. Not a problem. 74-72, seven overtime game. Jesus, that just sounds like an arena football game at that point. I think that's why I like arena football, is everything's like quicker, fast-paced. It's nice. I wish there was college arena football. You're right. Just a little, but it cost him there. Can I do that? Can I get a meeting with the NCAA for collegiate arena football? You can do it during the spring when there's not a ton going. Well, I guess there's still a ton. I guess there's still like basketball going on. Well, you know, you can end it towards the end of the end of the school year. That'll be great. Inbounds the ball. Peñazola, way up. Wow. The Cyclones. Good job. These guys are having trouble. You can just do it when it's really only like you start up, because like football is really one of the only real things going on during the fall. I think they have like a fall track and field, but that's about it as well. Maybe for all the kids who didn't make the actual football team, they could do the arena football. I didn't pass to him. God damn it. God damn it. Okay. Enough of this crap. A team that has the ability to create so many second chance opportunities. He said there we go. It is extremely important that his players do not get lazy boxing out their man. Giving up extra possessions. I mean, arena football can be done in pretty much any basketball arena anyway, so why not? Any place that's big enough to have a hockey rink is big enough to have an arena football field. Shepherd inbounds the ball under 11 minutes left in the half. Passes to the paint. Oh shit. Oh, that was okay. We're fine. They're now behind by 3. Really doesn't offense intend to pass to the other team. You make a good point. Leads him in. The steal by Tiny walls keeping the fans and players away. You just know, like, there would be some shit that would happen. Because think about it. Okay, so in... Okay, basketball is all right, but there's usually a bunch of crap in the way between the fans and the players. But imagine a college indoor arena football game where there isn't all that extra space on the sideline for, like... That's like where security and stuff goes. You're basically just being thrown into the crowd. I feel like college age kids can get into that. The idea of a front row to a college arena football game, and a very good chance that you could either catch an errant field goal for a free football, or you catch an actual player that goes flying over the boards. Both of which I've seen multiple times over the course of the last season in indoor football. Passes it up court. The TV ratings would skyrocket. What smooth moves he has. Not everybody. I can only imagine a student section trying to, a student section in an arena trying to distract someone from kicking the, you know, extra point field goal. And the riots that would happen from college kids trying to get the free footballs that end up in the crowds. Under 9 minutes left in the half. Because arena football don't give no fucks compared to the NFL. Like, you can't have an... Like, I don't know if you know that, but you can't really have an NFL football. Like, if a field goal goes errant or something ends up in the crowd, you can't keep that shit. They're going to come grab it. They're going to come get it. Arena football don't give a shit. I can't believe I haven't gotten a free football at this point. We've gotten close, I think, just because of some errant field goals. This sounds less like football and more like The Purge. I mean, if you put a bunch of drunk college kids in a game like that, they probably would. Basketball already gets crazy come, like, you know, NCAA tournament time. I can only imagine the idea of having that plus the football aura plus having gameplay that close to people. God damn it. Ah, there we go. Thought you were the only one to play this and also play NCAA 14. I will say there are a lot of people who are doing NCAA 14 dynasties. A lot less people who are still doing College Hoops dynasties. I know that because I get a huge influx of people talking about it every March. That is, that's probably my, that's like my, if there's such a thing as YouTube Christmas, YouTube Christmas comes to me every March. That is when I get my biggest influx of subscribers, of people going, oh my God, college hoops.
He said he wants to collapse their defense into the paint and prevent the entry pass.
Oh, shit.
We'll see if it works.
What? Come on. Count the shot. Hey, Barkin, what's up?
Shepard inbounds the ball. Peñazola brings it up
the floor. You do both dynasties? Nice. I do as well. I'm slightly less successful in the football one. I'm not as good at NCAA 14 as I am at college hoops. I've at least won a couple of national titles here. YouTube Christmas and the algorithm makes the thumbnail accidentally sexy. Why do you think I put Jahlil Okafor in my XBA thumbnails? Hey! Oh, shit. Why didn't you go in? All right. Now, as long as you still got the points. Play with updated rosters. I mean, I didn't. Something was wrong with my Horizon when I was trying to put the save games in there. So I couldn't play with the most updated ones. To be fair, these rosters were up when I played, when I started playing College Hoops. These rosters were updated, but that was also, Jesus, 3 years, at least 3 years ago. So, and I'm now 12 seasons. I'm now in my 12th season. So the rosters at one point were accurate, but now 12 seasons in, everyone's long gone.
Outright.
Oh, shit. Come on. Hey! Oh, shit. Oh, come on.
Stolen away by Iowa State.
There you go, there you go, there you go, there you go, there you go. Him.
There were just too many defenders around him.
All right, what do we got? What do we got here? There you go. There you go. Drive to the hoop. There you go. Oh. This had updated rosters. At least when I started doing it in 2015, when this one started, I think I had as recent as 2017. But yeah, I'm pretty sure even now, if I look on Operation Sports, there's probably at least. Well, oh, God, I don't remember the last time this was updated, to be honest. I haven't checked it in a while because I haven't had a need for college hoops rosters. But they still sometimes technically update this. Okay. Cool. Good old Grambling days, go almost undefeated in the regular and get a first or second round exit. Yeah. Probably because we weren't beating that, like, we weren't taking on too many good teams. We would have the occasional Kansas win, you know, something like that, but then we faced actual competition and we just kind of crapped the bed. You never realize how many you've done? I know, it feels so weird. What is going on? Hey, are we going to... There you go. Jesus Christ. Yeah, I know. It feels weird to know that, like, I'm 12 seasons into this series now. There actually is a 30-season limit. I think I might actually just try to go for that. Just be like, hey, why not? Let's try to go for that. Let's try to just... Let's try to, like... We'll get to the end of this. There will be an actual end. That's a long two, but oh well. And get beat by like Syracuse, yeah. That Florida game, man. I always talk about it. I don't even remember which season that is anymore. It was so many years ago now. So many seasons ago, that Florida game that I had. Like, I pulled a Northern Iowa. Where I was like, I'm up by like 8 with 40 seconds left, and I'm like, I'm going to the Sweet 16. I finally did it. And then Florida just stomped on my hopes and dreams.
Well, it looks like they're getting set to inbound the ball. Substitution.
Bum.
Inbounds the ball. Iowa is struggling on defense, and Tracy has a quick report from their bench.
The Hawkeyes coach is not at all happy with the drought they're going through and told his assistant.
Oh, you know what song I've been obsessed with this week? And I don't even know if I feel like admitting this. It's that fucking League of Legends song that came out a couple weeks ago. I don't play League of Legends, but I'm obsessed with that pop star song. I don't know why. It's not even something I normally listen to. It's just so goddamn catchy.
Pass to the elbow. Backs him down. Clifton.
Oh,
with
shit.
The shot. Can't get the
All right, we're still good.
They're still down seven. Catches it. Left wing.
It's fine. It's fine. It's fine. Oh. Okay.
That one was drilled.
Yeah, like, what the fuck you doing? I just, like, okay.
Pippen gets it right side.
I always have to sometimes look for, like, some of the, like, buzzer. I think I've only had a couple of buzzer beater moments so far. Like, I think my two best moments was the near impossible, like, Grambling win over Kansas with the buzzer beater from, I guess it wasn't too bad how far away it was. But then there was the one with, I think it was in my second season of San Diego State, where I think it was either in the Sweet 16 or Elite 8. And I had a three-point, shot from so far away, only Stephen Curry usually shoots from there. I shot it from Stephen Curry land and somehow drained it to tie the game and save my tournament hopes. I remember because I was playing like garbage that game, and then that happened. And then we just turned on our basketball ability. Oh, crap. Nope. All right. Well, they're still not doing a whole hell of a lot to try to stop us. In your San Diego State games, yeah, that one.
They now have a double-digit lead. The end.
Where we just did hot garbage, and then I just pulled it out at the end.
Good from downtown.
Oh, my stomach hurts.
This looks like,
yeah, I checked out the IHOP
here.
That they finally they built it. They built an IHOP down the road for me, and it looks like they're gonna build a couple other things. I don't know what it's gonna be, but generally how strip malls go. It's just like enough for like a couple of small shops. So knowing how it generally tends to go, it's probably going to be like a Sprint store. I live in the nice part of town, so I'm not thinking it's going to be Cricket or Boost. Even Sprint is probably looked down upon. It's amazing the type of people when you live in a richer part of the area. It's not like I live in some like really nice rich place. But man,
swings it to the left wing.
if they believe they are underneath of you, the way some people will treat you.
Pep catches it in the paint.
Oh, get that! Get that shit out of here! Get all that shit out of here!
Passes out left. Backs
all right, all right, all right. We need the they're double teaming the cheesy center. And they're just still not guarding my guards. Blew the doors off the... Oh, yeah. I blew the doors off the team in the championship. I remember that. I was like, how did I just destroy them like this?
Tippett bounces into the free throw line from downtown. The shot was short by Neighbors. This crowd
there
is
go.
Going
Come
insane.
On.
I love the energy of this
There
building.
You go. There you go.
That's
still...
Them.
Are you going to... Like, there you go. At least you put a hand up that time.
36-26. What do you think of the first half, Bill?
I should start like my own personal drinking game just on stream. I don't even really drink, but I should make a drink and put it next to me. And every time I overhear my roommate yell, "Put it in," at his Rocket League game, I just take a shot. And we'll just see how the rest of the we'll just see how the rest of this goes.
Every shot he takes goes through. Tremendous effort from our player of the half.
Like, let's see how I really play.
We're all set to begin the second half.
Is he streaming? I don't think he's streaming. I'm pretty sure he's not. No, okay. Wasn't sure.
Inbounds it to start the second half.
He's very odd sometimes with his like he doesn't stream for the longest time and then he decided to.
Oh, he didn't.
I don't know.
He's shooting 66% really
passed out
of the
in like
game.
10 minutes.
Tracy Wilson has more on what went on at halftime. Tracy?
Well, at halftime, I talked with Coach Wilson. He told me that he thinks it is going to take
damn it.
A different approach for them.
Get shit on.
He went on to say that he wasn't going
fuck
to
fuck your defense.
Rotation. Even though he knows he has talent on the end of his bench, he felt that the players he used in the first half give him the best chance of winning this game.
Come on. Oh, my God.
Ah! To you, Vern.
Okay, Tracy.
Wow.
Got the message across.
You know, I actually watched that happen a few times at the Iowa State game. There were a lot of plays that even against a team like Omaha, I was like, man, I hope they don't do that against actual Big 12 teams because we're fucked if that happens. I was just watching it, and I was like, God, there were some real miscues there. And I get it. Everyone's going to have their miscues, but shit. If you want to have a chance against Kansas, don't do that.
Inbounds the ball.
Never drink CBD. Yeah, really I could see that. Because, yeah, I really never drink either.
How did he miss that one?
Ladies and gentlemen, Iowa basketball.
Shake it off and reload. Releases. Couldn't get
oh,
the shot.
Shit.
Was fouled and gets a trip to the line.
I don't think I hear Iowa. I don't think I hear Iowa State basketball game get taught. Well, actually, technically, those games generally tend to happen not here. Well, I guess maybe here, but they generally tend to happen in Des Moines, not at the actual colleges, because they actually do a thing every year, which I think I might try to get tickets to, called the Hy-Vee Classic, which is all four NCAA Iowa teams. At Wells Fargo Arena in Des Moines, doing two different games. And I think this year is Iowa State versus Drake and Iowa versus Northern Iowa. I believe that's what it is. Or it's not Iowa State. Iowa State's either facing Drake or Northern Iowa, and Iowa's facing the other team. I can't remember. I'm pretty sure it's Drake. Ah, come on. There you go. But yeah, generally sells quite well.
Just listen to the people in this building. 14 points and he leads all in scoring.
Is it just me or did I just watch like color shirts get did I never notice like render shirts rendering in the audience cuz I felt like they changed colors. Maybe I'm just going crazy. We should continue the shot selection thing. That's been doing okay for us. Everything else, I think we're pretty solid on. I'm a little hesitant. We do have Covington, Penizola, Hunt. We do have a good chunk of our guys out there. Get out of the court. We don't have our big men though. We don't have our big guys. So we're gonna have to mostly rely on shooters today. Or at least until we get the other dudes back. Or they could just not guard the guys as they run down the court. That one guy just gave up and he's like, eh, that's not my zone. Yeah, that's not where I have to go. Oh, he almost went. He almost went backcourt. Oh, shit. I just realized the mic was going goofy, too. Jesus Christ. I apologize for anyone's ears I might have blown out while I was doing that. Because I was like, why is my mic, like, maxing out sometimes? I might do that. I'm just okay. Just a quick plug-in should, like an unplugged plug-in should help. Just to make sure I haven't blown out anybody's ears. I'm getting tired. It feels weird. It feels weird that it's like 11 o'clock and I'm just like, man, I'm tired. I'm beat. To the rack. That dude just got the hell out of the way. I love this. I love their just complete lack of help defense as we drive to the hoop. It's like you can see it coming. You can telegraph this. We practically have I'm driving to the hoop written on his forehead. He still is like, nope, not my man. That's somebody else's job.
Bounces it to the left wing. Hunt catches it left wing from downtown.
Ah.
Clifton pulls it down.
Iowa is playing basketball like workers in a union. Yeah, that's not my job. If I do that guy's job, then he's gonna file a grievance. He'll get some unnecessary money. So I'm just gonna leave it alone.
Once the shot goes up, you keep fighting for those offensive boards to help your team out. It's stolen by Peñazola. That's his second steal of the contest. Hunt goes up, towers.
Dude, down. The vertical that he gets. The vertical. I think he's like 6'2".
Clifton.
Which really is what gets me. It's like, God damn, Nate Robinson out here. I guess Nate Robinson was even smaller than that. Yeah, it's like, Jesus.
Down low on that last shot.
It is so tough.
Oh, God damn it.
When they get it close like that. The last bucket down low was dropped in.
I'm almost up by 20, and I'm just kind of giving it up. Actually, I think I was up by 20, wasn't I?
Tracy?
Because it was, what, 57-37? Because they made the two, and they made another two. Well, now I need to make sure that I beat them. Now we're in some big boy games where I'll maybe go down when we're only only got like 4 minutes left, and I don't think we'll collapse super duper hard.
Corralled by Peñazola.
That was a tough shot.
That was close. That felt close.
Backs in.
Oh, God damn it! Yes, go.
Inbounds the ball.
Oh man.
The Hawkeyes have got a
I need to fire up Star Wars Episode 1 Racer, cuz it got released on Steam and I bought it, and I know it's probably a bit overpriced, but I think it was like $8. I was like, fuck it, it's $8, who cares? I want to play Star Wars Episode 1 Racer on my PC. I mean, I'm pretty sure I have the ROM on my computer, but, you know, just the ability to have that, why not?
Right side, passes it back to the right wing. Last tray off the mark by Weber.
You'll want another shot with that much.
I've been like sifting through other things I want to do. Oh, shit. I've been sifting through other things I want to do, like off stream. I don't know if anyone would be interested in it. But I had an idea, and I want to play Planet Coaster because I had an idea in Planet Coaster of a park where you make buildings and skyscrapers and stuff, and those are the facades for all your rides. Like, none of your rides actually stick out. I've seen a couple things that are very similar to that, but oh, God damn it. What are we doing?
But it's extremely dangerous. To toss it up like
but
that,
yeah, saw, I oh god, I was like looking at chat for a second. But I had the idea of trying to run something in Planet Coaster where I just make like these big building type things, and I stick the rides inside of them, and they're just like, you see people going in and out of various buildings, but you don't actually see the rides or even the shops or anything. That's what I want to make.
I'm not sure what went wrong there.
Then I also have to also think about the fact that that's probably going to take me forever.
Goes up, just missed it.
Ah.
No 3-point opportunity, but he'll go to the line for two. Shooting
two. Oh shit!
He misses the first.
I didn't expect him to hold it for like 3 seconds.
Good on number two.
There we go.
Wells inbounds the ball. About 4.5 minutes left in the second half. Weber step back over the
hey.
There, that's an over and back violation.
Obviously, that could have
man,
been
a lot
avoided.
Of backcourts happening
one of those
here.
Mental mistakes that happens
all right.
Every once
I make a
while.
Basket. I call it a day.
Covington. Hands it off. Backs in.
Come on, Timba. Goes up. Oh, there it is. Oh, he got it. He got it. All right. Up by 21. I think we're good. There's just over 4 minutes left. 70-52. Yeah, they didn't really come back, but that's all right. I'll take it. 3-0, and that was a home game. That was a big-time home game right there, which means we now get to extend that streak to 3. Extend our official home record to 28-4. And we are doing solid. Move on to next week here. We'll have a couple of road games that hopefully we can actually win. God forbid I try to put some competitive games up there and then we just lose all of them. Oh, I think I'd cry. You know what? We got enough points for it. Go talk to them. See if you can't get them to show up. Perfect, just enough. Alright, I don't see myself getting it, but we can still try. I mean, we still got time. And if he takes that, then the scholarship is rescinded and we hand it to this dude. No big whoop. Man, San Jose is trying to, I assume it's San Jose or St. Joseph's. It could be St. Joseph's, I guess. But yeah, they are trying to take these recruits. Go away. Alright. I think we're at a pretty good point right now. Oh, wait, no, I still got to go through another week. What am I doing? Sim it. All right, sim the game. Hey, we got a win. Got a win on the road. Got a loss on the road. That's all right. All right, North Carolina. Be the next one. 2-4 North Carolina. Oh, wait, no, I don't want to sim through the day just yet because I want to keep everything pretty set to this. I'll still try. Why not? I've got the points. Why not? There we go. All right. Oh, they seem interested. You know what? If they seem so interested in me, why not give him the time of day? Oh, shit. Why not have him give him the time of day? He seems highly invested in being here, so why not? Let's try it. Where is some of the places he wants? Okay, so he definitely wants to stay in the Midwest. Why not give him a reason? Oh, he's definitely not coming over. Ooh, I bet you he's the number one guy next season. I bet you Jeb Withers. I bet you he's next season's number one guy. You watch. Add him to the target list. Why not? Just find a couple guys who maybe want to do something. Like I said, I'll take whoever, man. If they're into being there, cool. Ooh, I've got a chance. Oh God, I'm running out of stuff for these guys to do. I'm running out of time. All right, I'll take a chance here. I'll take a chance. I like this. I like this. This is good. Maybe we can get some of these guys. God. Woo. 4-star, 6'7" center. Jesus Christ. Whatever. I'll grab him. Why not? Oh, I don't have enough. Oh, God. You know what? I'll add a freshman. I'll add a four-star guy in a few years. Why not? Why not? This freshman wants to be here? Sure. This guy really, yeah, he wanted to Iowa, Minnesota, Wisconsin. He kind of wanted to stay around the area. I forget where Marquette's at. Bradley, I mean, that's got to be around the area, I believe. And no, this guy's pretty much dead set on where he's at. This guy's like, I'll play for you guys. I'm only at 2 stars. Sorry. I only go for 3. Come back when you gain some skill. 3-star junior. I think I got a lot of dudes now. I think I've got a lot of juniors. I don't even know if I'm going to need them all. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we'll see what happens because, you know, I got some guys who would be kind of interested in being here. So why not? I think with my A-plus charisma, that would do me some good. And then a guy who just really wants to be with us. So why not? I was like, all right, if you really want to play for us, I'm not going to tell you no. So I think we're sitting pretty good. I don't think we're going to get this dude. I think he's pretty much decided on North Carolina or Kentucky. I don't even think I can get him up to 100% before the signing period starts. So, but that's all right. Because after this week, I think after this week, I'll be able to focus on the other dude. And that's fine. And then I'll have my 3 dudes for next year pretty much locked down. So let's go ahead and save this like that. And just want to thank you guys for coming out. It was about 2 hours 15. That was pretty good. I'm going to save it again just to be safe. I've had issues before. So I want to thank you guys for coming out. I greatly appreciate it. This is a good start to the new season. 4-1. You know, yeah, I would have liked to not lose so badly to Tulsa, but you can only do what you can do. Everyone did kind of a, okay, Covington really shit the bed on that one. Jesus. All right, so everyone did okay. Well, we can blame Covington for that. Shepherd didn't do too great either, but it's all right. So, yeah, thank you guys. And if you are watching this on YouTube, thank you very much for continuing to watch. And like I said, dude, we are at, aren't we at, we're pretty much at real time now, aren't we? Okay, it's, yeah, Wednesday, November 28th. That's where we're at. We're right at, we are at no, like Tuesday, November 27th right now. It's kind of insane that we started this 3 years ago and you start off in like 2007. We are now officially at a point where I am streaming this Wednesday, November 28th, 2018. And in the game, I am at Tuesday, November 27th, 2018. So, yeah. Because we'll definitely get these two done. And, yeah, so by the next time, after the next time I stream, we'll actually be into the future. So, it took quite a while, but we're there. So, thank you guys, and I will see you guys next time.